Let's make a quick setup of animations for this pig. First, we'll create the animation blueprint. It is very important that it be inherited from a NEME multi-node instance _DN. We'll create only one node called DynamicNode. Don't forget to update a NEME class and mesh. Next, we should create three functions. And just set the desired animations. First, we will have to create a special class because we have only one jump animation. And in the animation, you must set the position for notify where a loop should be. I'll slow down play rate a little, because the animation is too short. Do not forget to configure max walk speed, because this parameter is responsible for the type of motion animations that will be selected. Now I will set the opportunity to turn to a slow walk by pressing the control button. The plugin will accomplish the rest of work. Please note that instead of slow walking, running, you can make the running and sprint set. Now let's take a look at the jump. You can configure loop and transition speed parameters to make it look better. Now let's add the attack animation. It can be easily done. But as you can see, this method can be applied only if the character is not moving. But there is the possibility to make blend by bone in the plugin. Set just the right bone. Let's add a new state rest now, that allows our pig to lie down. In the plugin, this is done very simply. And now just set the necessary animations. I want to note that it is not necessary to set all the animations. The function will work even if you have only one of them. Now let's make the character to enter this state by pressing the button. As you can see, all the blends work automatically. This parameter is needed when you exit the rest mode without using GitHub animation. For example, you want to start running from the line position immediately. It indicates the blend animation speed used in this case. In addition to lay machine, you can use custom machine for any additional modes. Now let's talk about the way to set variations for animations. Let's set variations for idle as an example. In order to do that, create a special class and configure it in the begin play event. Set any number of animations, give them a chance to be applied as well as the additional settings. Do not forget to tick off change in runtime, otherwise the animation will change only after its new start. That is, for idle, a change will occur only after a run or jump. And with the tick, the animation will always change. For a better result, you can configure for idle the transition time parameter, as well as the chance set parameter group. As the example, I increased the time limit for the second animation, because it is longer than the first one.